Let me know when I... Hello. I'm Michele Lombardi. I'm the presenter of the today seminar about jewelry photography. Just a brief explanation about me and my experience, and then we'll start to talk about the we can start to talk about the conference and topic. So, I apologize, I'm just a little bit new to this type of media, and I normally held this conference in presence. So, what I did in the last 20 years is work as a designer and inventor of new equipment for make photo of jewelry and other small items. This allowed me to meet a lot of jewelers all around the world, and getting their feedback and their opinion about the photo that they need for the different purposes and for the different usage that they have in their professional life. So even if I'm a technician, I'm an electronic engineer, I'm PhD in electronic engineering, I took photo for more than 35 years. Because it was also my passion. Started when I was just 18. I mixed my experience in electronics and mechanics and designing that I had with many international companies all around the world, Hewlett-Packard, Motorola, and others, with my passion for photography. And I invented the new devices that are designed especially as a studio for particular purposes. My first patent was held more than 20 years ago, in the May of 2000, and it was about a jeweler studio. And now I can say that I have more than 20 years of experience working with jewelers and listening to their need. So, The present seminar is about why taking photo of your jewel. That means why is the natural question that everyone has to ask himself when he does something. So the first thing that we have to think about is why we are taking this photo. What is the purpose we have in mind when we take the photo? And along my experience, I identified four different purposes, five different reasons to make photo, to document these are technical photo. These are like memories. It's like drawing a sketch of something. It's to analyze, to sell your jewelry. So what we call commercial photo. Photo that is required for the decision process of a customer as to choose one jewel instead of another, to find the best jewel for his particular need. And you can consider that this customer, this visitor, this observer can be a professional one. If you are working in the business to business, so your customer are jewelers, but can be the final consumer of the jewel, and they have different way to look at the product. Because they're different are the purpose where they are looking for a jewel. There is a other more sophisticated type of photography, the artistic and the creative photography that is not exactly the commercial photo. We split the two type of photo because a different way, different techniques and different purpose they have. And photo for emulation, to inspire, when the people have to look at the picture and think, I will be like this, or I like this situation, I like this feeling, and I want to be in line with this. This is the inspiration photo, and it's normally model photos. So it's very important the type of model you choose, the expression, and so on. But let's take a better view of each of these photos, and we start with the photo that are the easiest one, easiest under the technical point of view, because they are photos that are very simple to take, very simple to understand how to make it. They are technical photo. The technical photo are photo where the purpose of it is to document, to get the information from the images and preserve this information. So the purpose of this is to measure, analyze, and save information about the real item that is in front of the camera. But remember, it's very important that this photo should be used inside your company and not shared outside. Because if you share this photo, you have to consider one very simple thing that is in front of you in this picture. Those photos are ugly, not very nice. They do not represent the object in its whole beautiness. It's not the best point of view. It's a technical point of view. So you have to identify the main axis of a three-dimensional subject, like a jewel, and take the photo from this. Technically speaking, in a technical drawing, they are called the orthogonal projection of the item. And many of you that makes sketches of the jewel that they design, they know very well this point of view because it's the base in order to build or analyze the jewel. It's also very, very useful that they preserve a real size information. So you will be able to measure a diameter, a size, a shape, a distance on this photo. So it's important that you have a reference for it. As you can see in the previous example, you can use a millimeter reticle against the object in order to have a reference, or you can shoot photo in actual size. Let's talk now about the most difficult photo. It's not the correct term. More difficult than technical photo. That they are commercial photo. Commercial photo should provide images of the jewels that the observer, that is normally someone that is going to purchase this product, be able to choose one item versus another one. So they must provide the information about the beautiness of the product, because when you sell jewelry, you are selling beautiness, you are selling design, not only precious material and precious gems, precious metal, you are selling design overall. And when you are selling to the final consumer, you want that he get fall in love with your product and choose it. He may fall in love for different reasons, but he has always to imagine the jewel on his body or on its beloved. Because sometimes it's a gift, but you have to transmit a good image of your jewel. So an image that provides many points of view, not just one, the top, the side, the other side, in order to completely understand the design just by one shot, one point of view. Later you can provide more information, but you have to understand that the decision process will occur against hundreds of other items. So you must provide the clearest images without distracting element. This is a typical application for catalog images, where you can choose the best point of view in order to provide information about the shape, the thickness, the texture, the color, the type of metal, the type of stone that you use. The purpose of this photo is to sell, and the purpose of this photo is to communicate external to your company, with the customer or with some reseller. So it's very important that you provide to the observer the right point of view of your product. So the object must be as it's on the body, as you see the ring on your finger, as you see the earrings on your ear when you look at the mirror, as you see the necklace when it's on your neck and you look in the mirror as well, or the bracelet on your wrist. So provide the different fantasy position make a catalog not very understandable. For example, I can show you the previous photo of the technical point of view. If you provide an image like this ring from the top, the people neither understand that this is a ring if you provide just this point of view. You must neither if the, you provide an image like this. They are confusing. They are very precise from one point of view, but it's not a total description of the product. So people cannot understand that this is a ring. It can be a pendant, can be an earring, can be a brooch. When you take a photo of a ring like this, you understand that this is a ring. So it's very important that in the commercial photo, sales, you can see the typical element that connect the jewel with your body. I call this the characteristic element of this photo. For example, for a ring, the typical element is the hole for the finger. If you don't see the hole for the finger, you do not understand that that is a ring. The typical element for an earring is the mechanism, the earring, clip or pin on your ear. So if you see this, you understand that this is not a pendant like this, it's an earring. If you see this, you understand that this is not a pendant or a brooch, it's a ring. So remember, Sam, always to show the characteristic element of this. Sometimes doesn't appear, and the characteristic element is the shape that the things takes on the body. For example, the typical shape of a necklace. You understand this is a pendant because you see the chain of a necklace here, and that it's like hanging on this thin chain. I spend more time and the most of my time on commercial photo because commercial photo is also the vast majority of the photo that you will take in your professional life. Because any product that you make need a commercial photo, otherwise you don't show to your customer. Not all the product that you will take need artistic photo because maybe can become too complex to present a complete catalog of artistic photo and can be disappointing for the observer to see very complex images. So for this reason, we recommend to keep a standard, homogeneous background. And so the, every picture in your catalog website as well will provide the same background and make the picture more comparable one to the next. And among all the possible background, white is highly recommendable because it's the easiest to make. It can be done even automatically. Our equipment is designed for that, but it's not the only reason. We can make photo in black background, silver background, in fantasy background. But the white background, white is an absolute color. It's always the same in every picture. So you can make the same white in all the picture, and you can do it automatically. You can also make the same picture and in the same situation, in the same size. So the image became much easier to have a look and understand which is the product that I am looking for. Next picture. Situation. As I told you, I spend more time, most of my time on commercial photo, and that there is the reason that you take 90%, 95%, or even 100% of your photo as a commercial photo. If you don't need the internal documentation, so technical photo, and you don't need the other type of photography like artistic, this is the vast majority of your time. Let's talk briefly about artistic photo. In the artistic photo, you can take any shape you want. The purpose is to impress and stimulate emotion. So, for example, this in this photo, what you can use to communicate a sensation and emotion? Obviously, you need a good picture of your jewel, but you need also to provide emotion, provide feelings. So you can play with the background for this purpose. As in this picture, this is a summer line jewel, and correctly, they have used a background that remember the sun, remember the seashore, the. This is the way you can create not only artistic is too hard, but I would say creative photography. You can play this in any position you want, and it's important to have in mind a project about the photography, because this is a marketing communication. You communicate something about your product, you communicate something about you. So when you think about a romantic line, you can put in a flower or in an old picture background. But anyway, you have to think about this. So a standard photo for catalog, a standard commercial photo require a few seconds to be shoot. You require many minutes to be designed, or even hour. It's a creative process. Model photo show how the object stay on the body as main purpose, but also do not forget that the model choice communicate emotion, communicate emulation. So you have to think when you make the casting for the model, what is your target audience, and choose a model that is reasonable. These jewels must communicate a sensual, a sexy feeling. So a young lady is good for it, while if it would communicate fidelity, this would have been a long relationship. This would have been a wrong model for this. So always think about it in creativity to be aligned to your marketing target. Obviously, you have to place on the body as worn. But the model can also play with them. And the purpose, anyway, is to inspire emotion and communicate your brand. Now, we have talked about what are why you are taking photo of your jewels. Now let's talk how you can use this photo. So where you place your photo in order to show your jewel. We have distinguished the traditional media versus new media, and traditional media has, as you can read, is something that exists for in the previous century, and even before, for some one of these, newspaper and magazine is more than 300 century of advertising, billboard as well. You can, but these are the traditional one. You would be, especially because you are young, majority of you are young, and doesn't have a big budget, a big company. You should be more focused on the new media that provide to you a convenient and accessible way to communicate. The emailing require that you organize a mailing list of people that is interested with your product, but is a very effective communication. Video conference can be one-to-one or a webcast like this. So it's completely different type of message. What you do in a video conference one by one is a very similar of what you can do in the desk of your shop. A webcast should be designed before, because you have much less interactivity with the other people. The best way to communicate is on your own shop, on your own website, because a website that is under your control can be created as you want, but it's also something that is difficult to create and require a long time to have up and running for many reasons. It's like if you built your shop but from the scratch. So you have to build the floor, you have to build the walls, you have to build the roof, you have to design all the furniture, choose the furniture, and then you are ready to propose your product in your shop windows. But still you need to find people that comes to your shop. So it requires time, but to provide the maximum degree of freedom to you. Inside this web shop, website, you can place a video chat that is exactly like your desk. So consider always when you design your approach to the internet communication that very frequently they have a very good analogy with the reality. The website is like a shop. A video chat is like you on your desk when you talk with your customer. And the marketplace? Well, marketplace, a different type of shop. Is a shop that is already done by someone else. It's like a shop in a mall. So, like a shop in a mall, there is many advantages, but there are some disadvantages. So you have to take in account both. The disadvantage is that the platform is already done and set some limitation to your freedom. For example, Amazon accepts only images in white background of a square format, or eBay as well. Your presentation can be limited in some form. You cannot use 3D animation to show to your customer in a marketplace normally. So marketplace reduce your freedom, but it's already built. It's ready to use. And the marketplace can share with you your revenue, like the Amazon does, for example, but many others that ask for commission, or can be some like a shop that is rent for an annual fee. Last but not least, there is also the social network as a communication media. Consider the analogy with the play with the open space in a road, in a plaza. The purpose of the different type of communication bring you to have different approach to marketing. Offline marketing is the marketing of traditional media, and online marketing is the marketing of new media. The most important difference is the way of communicate. In traditional media, you communicate to many people, but you don't get an answer from them. So you can inform, there is one directionality, and you don't choose the people that is in front of the television set or is in front of your billboard in the road. And you get very few feedback and data, but overall you have to spend a huge amount of money because it's so unspecific. The new media can provide communication in multiple directions, not just bidirectional. It's not just that you communicate to many and many communicate to you, but all the people then speak to others, can forward your link, can provide feedback to you as a like or email or purchase orders. The purpose can be many, 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 and you can manage different way to talk. For example, we will talk in the next conference about how to make the photo and how to use it, showing example of 3D media animation, showing example how you can make a video conference in a live communication. The big advantage of this is that you need a low budget on and you can specific on a target, inviting the people that you want. You can get immediately feedback and data. Very quickly, rising importance of internet. Many of you are young and this is something they have already understood. I would say that this slide is overall for people of my age that thinks jewels can be sold. The vast majority of jewel is sold just by traditional shop because people want to touch the jewelry. Yes, it's still true. Even if this figure are 2 years old, was pre-COVID, is 2018 data, consider that the online sale is a very small niche, and there will remain the same for some times. But, and the rest, the 92% is a sales in the real shop in 2 years ago. But if you look which are influenced by images, information, websites, social media, you discover that offline sales in a shop was decided looking on the online media. So they take good images, show good images, get in communication with many people will influence a lot your real shop sales. The next seminar, this is just a brief anticipation for you, will be how to take a commercial photo of jewels. And the difficulty that you have to do, you have to meet and solve. And I will show our approach to do this. That the fact that very frequently you can take photo, but you can transform very quickly and easy in what you need for your commercial purpose. Just a change of point of view, a change of background, transform an ordinary photo like this one, a rotation, transform this in a final conversion photo like this. And you will see how to make different photo of different items. So my invitation is to attend the next seminar, how to take photo of jewels. And I'm ready to answer to your question.
Hello, so I have one question, Mikkel. Like, is it possible that you would come back to the slide about the percentages, how it was influenced by online media? I didn't quite understand.
Can you see it now?
Not yet. It's a black screen. Yes, yes. Now we see. Yes, so my question is, so 70%, it was influenced, 70% influenced 8% of online sales and 22% of...
No, 22% plus 70% are sales influenced by the online, but was offline sales. So 92% was sales done in a real shop compared to sales done in an online shop that is just was just 8% 2 years ago. This means that by the website, the sales was 8%, but that the same website has influenced about three quarters of the shop sales, because from here
now understood
to here was offline sales, but this part was decided in the shop, and this part was decided online. So your presence in the social media, if people see for the first time your jewel in a web page, in an advertisement, in a banner, in a marketplace like the one that is going to organize Amber Trip, so in a gallery, there is the vast majority of our time now is getting information from internet, not getting information going physically in a shop. So I would expect that now these two numbers are exchanged. So I expected that nowadays, especially after the closure of the shop, as you sadly know, this number should be exchanged in this situation. Pure offline sales, in my opinion, now it's 8%, 5%. And the rest is something that has been influenced by the online. And I expect that now the online sales is more than twice than it was 2 years ago, should be about 20%, 25%. Obviously, it depends on the market, decision that you make, so how you push on instead of shops.
Okay, thank you for explaining.
Any other questions?
We have two questions from YouTube listeners. So first question would be, is your 4Pro equipment suitable to take the technical photos?
Yes, for sure. The reason, because it's a just a second, I find a way to go back to the live view. I am not a very expert of, yeah. So now I don't, do you see me now?
No.
Or you still see the screenshot?
Oh, I see the screen, your screen share. Oh, yes.
Okay. Now you see me?
Yes.
Okay, if you see me, I can explain quickly how to make you put inside a studio, just a second, I have to enlarge the view. Can you see the studio here?
Yes.
Do you see my live view? Okay, I point my real finger and not by... You put the jewel inside and you can take a different point of view moving around the jewel. So the technical for you simply place a jewel as it stay, and you can always find the best point of view for a technical view, that is the top, the front side, the lateral side, because you simply rotate 90 degrees. On the other, if the question would be how it's easy to make a commercial photo, it's almost the same simplicity, because normally commercial photos show more than one side of the item. So instead of going in the main point of view, top view, side view, the other side view, you go in the middle and you decide what is most important part of the jewel, moving and looking, finding the best point of view. For this reason, I normally, in my experience, I discovered that the people that design their own jewel are their best photographer, because they maybe the first time they don't have the experience for the technique, but when they discover how to move around it, they already know what is the most beautiful point of view of their jewel. So they are the best photographer because they are the people that best know their own product. So they know if this finger, this ring should be looks like this, or looks like this, or look like this. They have the mechanical freedom to move around the product, and they have in their mind what is the best point of view of that particular jewel. For this reason, very frequently, designer of jewelers or experienced seller of jewels are better photographer than professional photographer.
Thank you for your explanation. Then we have another question. Is how much does this equipment cost with this camera? What is the price?
Well, the system is modular, so it can fit the need of many people and can fit a different need. The cheapest possible situation is to take the same degree of freedom of movement by a smartphone, without the arm, without the macro lens, without many things. It's a low-cost approach, an initial approach that costs less than 1,000 euros. It allows to move the smartphone in any way you want around the jewel. And this is what we call a social studio. But for a more professional photography, it's better to use a camera instead of a smartphone, because the lens is better, because the lens provides more degree of freedom, making zooming out for large necklaces, zooming in for smaller earrings. So, and also it can provide the movement that can be used for make the video of jewels. This is not just a photo studio. It all became by the arm also a video studio, as you see. Now I'm using as a stative to find the best point of view, and it stay there. But moving, I can film a video, and you can have the effect that the jewel moves around a white background, so it moves around itself. In reality, it is not the jewel that moves, it's the camera. This is a low-cost approach to video and 3D animation that is also possible. The cost of a studio complete with the light box, like social studio, and but all completed with the arm, the macro lens, the adapter for your camera, and the software to remote control everything is less than 2,000 euros. If you already have a camera, it's very likely that you can use your own camera. We can adapt to the studio, changing the adapter, changing the lenses, so we can provide the adaptation to your need. But even if you purchase a simple system for the smartphone, it can evolve after time because the solution is modular. So you can purchase the other part later, and you can make something that was designed just for social network, something suitable for professional photography. And if you get a system for professional photography, that, as I told you, cost less than 2,000 euros, it can become a system with motors that moves by themselves, making 3D animation and video on many axes, controlled by the computer. In this solution, you can have the maximum level of interactivity with your camera. And I will show in the next seminar, a real usage of it, both in live video conference and filming for publishing on your website, the 3D animation. Because the process is very straightforward, it's very fast and easy. A system for 3D animation is an additional kit that you can apply on the previous studio. It's modular, as I told you. And in that case, the total cost is about 3,500 euro. So even if the price is the lowest in the world of this capability, we understand that for many companies and especially many artisans and many small one-man-only company can be an important and significant investment. So normally we suggest walk with the length of your step. You can do one step after the other, and only when you discover that the previous step pays back in terms of more sales, because this is a machine to sell the jewelry. This is not a machine to make jewelry. This is a machine to sell the jewelry. It has to pay back by its sales. So you can do step by step. The steps are social studio for less than 1,000 euro, complete professional photo studio for less than 2,000 euro, and 3D robotic video and photo studio that also is applicable for, I don't know how many of your visitors is doing 3D design, but taking photo with motor-controlled position can also be used for three-dimensional scanning. So they can do reverse engineering of something that they have done with different technology. For example, if they are used the traditional technique of molding by hand, they can reproduce and have a 3D model using the equipment as a scanner, as a 3D scanner. For this reason, we also sell them as a 3D scanner. And in many countries, there is technologies, financing to support this evolution of the technology. So sometimes it's a good idea to purchase as a scanner instead of a studio, just to have the possibility to assess this funding. The equipment is the same. So you can use when you need as a scanner, when you need as a studio.
Okay, thank you. Does anyone else have any questions for Michele? I guess for today, no. So thank you for today's seminar.
So that we can maybe arrange the seminar for January 9th for the 2000.
Okay.
Also, the
take note of this and be ready to be surprised. Because what normally surprised the people during the fair, looking at our or during the seminar, where I normally held the seminar about 1 hour, 2 hours, because I also teach how to make photography, I teach how to make video and animation, is that people expect that the process is complex. For example, I took a photo, has defects, and I have to clean by Photoshop every defect like a painter. No, our approach is best you get in the reality, best you have in front, around, and in front and rear your jewel, less work you will do. 1 second saved in photography means hours saved in photo editing. So the people will be amazed to see that I will take a photo of a ring in about 20 seconds, or I will take a video of a ring in about a couple of minutes.
So let's go arrange for the next seminar next year, 2021, January 9th, the same time in Italy. Now you have...
Yeah, for me it's okay. How is for you to have the seminar on Saturday? This is a novelty, a new thing for me. For me, it's good.
Also for me is good because I don't know the...
January the 9th, anyway, okay, at the same time. Yeah. I was wonder about, I think the seminar held on Saturday is a bet. Many people is not in the office, but understand, visiting your website and discovering your Baltic jewelry gallery, I understand that your type of audience is not the standard jewelers that I normally met. Your audience, I expect, is much younger, much more technology skilled than my usual audience in traditional, where many people has my age. As you can see, I'm white hair.
This is our community. It's like we have our work and it's our hobby. It's together, okay? Because yes, it's our real life. We're not taking the jewels. We will talk only from Monday until Friday. No, we sleep with the jewels inside, with our ideas. And they see you can help us because I can see the future. A jewelry person cannot be without photo. I think in the future, when you're giving the name of your name, so not writing the jewelry person, photo jewelry person. Because without photo, because nobody can make the photo better than jewels by themselves, because he likes to...
I agree. I also experienced this part.
You said this in webinar. The jewels is the best because we know how to do it.
They feel it.
Yeah, because of course we can order to photographer to make this and this and this, but it's the not him work.
Because an experience, it's difficult to find on the market a photographer that is experienced in taking photo of jewelry. Even in Italy, where there is many city with the long tradition of jewelers, there are very few photographers that has developed the experience on taking photo of jewelry. And the way a photographer, an external photographer, see, look, and choose the point of view of the jewels is different than the one of jewelers. A typical example that I do is that when a photographer take a photo of a jewel of a ring, he normally focuses his lens on the diamond, on the main stone of the ring, and leave the rest of the ring unfocused in order to drive the attention just on the main item, like he does in a portrait, where he focuses in the eyes and try to unfocus the background. A jeweler has a different point of view. A jeweler sells the whole ring, not just the diamond on the top of the ring. And for this reason, a jeweler wants a different type of photo, wants a photo where everything is in focus. This is an easy example, but I can show many examples of this, and I will do in the next seminar. This seminar has took almost twice the time that we expected, but well, photography is my passion and my hobby since about 35 years, so for me it's not a problem. I hope that also for you has been interesting.
Okay, grazie Michele. I wish you have good Christmas, happy New Year's, and 2021 is successful for you to be also. So we're waiting you back in January 9th.
And I hope that we have the opportunity to meet in a real Amber trip in Vilnius. And I will be happy to take some photographer of the magazine with us in order to take the reportage of the Baltic jewelry in the magazine that we manage in Italy.
Thank you. Grazie.
Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Thank you,
everybody.
Ciao.